Welcome to CodeTech Facts. In this video, we are going to see how to create a REST API in Dino. We are going to use the REST API using the application. As the application object is in the different package, I am changing the package to and creating, importing the application, the port as it is. Constant app is equal to new application. This part I don't need out of it. Then app dot listen port number of port. Let's check it out. There is no middleware to request the process and all those things. So we need to add the middlewares for that. For the middleware, I'm going to use the router. Declare one router. Router.get method. Using the response, need the response. Adding the response followed by response dot body equal to app dot use, adding the middleware of the router. Dot routes app dot router dot allow all methods. I need to allow all the methods. Just ordered all the methods. Let's see. Now it started without any error message. Let's check it out in browser. It works. Let's create a customer REST API. I have already declared an interface with ID, name and mobile number. I declare a constant variable with the customer array. Let's make it as a global. For that I am declaring a global variable as global this as any dot customers equal to customer. Constant customers DB. I have to export this. And export the variable. I am declaring with the customer array. We can start creating with the customer controller.ts. Can start importing the packages. Import from the same package which is used for the request response on the application. As we need request, response and router. And we can import the customer class. We need to include the .ts as it is a model approach based on the URL, the file is getting imported. So we have to add the .ts also. We can start creating the class. Class customer controller. Declaring the router for the endpoint. Prefix is the endpoint which is used for the router. V1 slash customer. The next step is to declare the customer. In the customer, I am going to add all the endpoints for the get, post and the put methods. Dot get customer, I have to add the method get customer of, it will have the response object as we will be responding the list of customers. It returns the response. Response.body equal to customer DB. That's it, will return all the customers. The next one is we have to get the single customer information. Followed by ID, that's the parameter, colon ID is parameter, it's same as the Express.js. Oh, we need to declare it as customers here. We start creating the customer. Private get customer. Declaring the params. Next is response. Params is any, it can be any type. And response, we need to find the variable. We can use of the TypeScript filter. The customer can be find or it can be an invalid ID. So we have to define the customer as well as the undefined. Customer.find ID equal to it will be written in the string format. So we have to add prefix add plus params.id. If we found the customer, it should return the customer object. Or it should return 404. The customer is not found. Next is to add one customer. Post of, it will be the default because we are going to add the customer. This dot add customer. For adding the customer, we will be adding the request as well because the request will return the payload, that's the body content which is going to be post method, and we need the response as well. We can get the body object, that's the customer. It will be async method. We need to add the await request, it should be small, right? It's not working. Let me check. Oh, I have to add comma. Now it's working. Request.body. Going to add the await. You need to wrap it with the await, I think. Okay, we can wrap it. After the await, I'm getting the value. That's correct. Then customer DB dot push. I'm not going to validate and all those things, as this is not the DB information. I'm just pushing those information to the predefined array. So I'm adding as it is. Status equal to 201 created. I am responding with OK. We need to add the async in the private, then the method or in the function or method, because the thing is, it's in the top level, but we have declaring the method, means if you are using await, then surely you have to add the async as well. The next is to next we can start with the put method for updating. Put, we need to have the ID as the parameter. Colon ID, this dot, update customer. We can add the update method. Async update customer with the parameter for the ID. Request object and response. Request is to get the body information. I am copying from the get method. Oh, I have not declared the informations, data types. Params is any, request, response. If the customer is available, update with the new customer. Need to get the information from body dot value. Going to update with the previous payload. Dot name equal to new object, that is getting from the post method. It can be null, so I am checking with the null operation. Name customer dot mobile equal to new value dot mobile. So we have added the get method followed by getting one customer, and next is add customer and put customer. We need the router to be created an object, so customer dot router, and exporting the default, export default the customer router. We can include the default customer router in our main server page. Dot slash customer controller dot ts. It's the default, so we don't want to add with the curly brackets. It's not over. Okay, we can add directly. The next step is to add it, the customer router, into a middleware. That customer router dot, we have written the routing routes. That's it. We can validate with the postman. I have included in the HTTP 400, so HTTP colon localhost colon 400, sorry 4000, API slash v1 slash customer. I got the response. Let's add an another value. I have included with the global this, so it will be available for the session. So pasting this. For adding, we need to declare it with post body content. Adding with the raw data, I have to change with this JSON. ID normally we will be the auto generated numbers that we can change in our next video, which is going to be the database. Jack mobile. Let's check it out. It should throw give the 201 and OK. Yes, it's 201 and created. Let's check it out. Thanks for watching. Please share your feedback and questions in the comment section. If you like the video, subscribe and share with your friends. See you soon in the next video.